Okay, Michael, what's the answer?
So, all right, does it make sense to repeat an attribute along a path in a tree? So, it seems like it could be no, in that, you know, if we're looking at attributes like, you know, is A true, then later we wouldn't ask again, is A true, because we would already have known the answer to that.
Right, and by the way, information gain will pick that up for you automatically.
Ah, it doesn't have to be a special thing in the algorithm. If you consider an attribute that you've already split on, you're not going to gain any information, so it's going to be the worst thing to split on.
Exactly.
All right,
okay,
but it seems like maybe you're trying to lead us on because this we're in the continuous attributes portion of our show.
Okay, well, what's the answer there? Is the answer not also false?
Well, we wouldn't want to ask the same question about the same attribute. So we wouldn't have age between 20 and 30 and then later ask again age between 20 and 30. But maybe we'd want to ask, you know, given that we're less than 20, are we teenagers or not? So we might have a different range on age later in the tree.
So that's exactly right, Michael. So the answer is no, it does not make sense to repeat an attribute along a path of the tree for discrete valued attributes. However, for continuous valued attributes, it does make sense because what you're actually doing is asking a different question. So one way to think about this is that the question, is age in the 20s or not, is actually a discrete valued attribute that you've just created for the purposes of the decision tree. So asking that question again doesn't make sense, but asking a different question about age does in fact make sense. So once you know that you are not in the 20s, you might ask, well, am I less than 20 years old, maybe a teenager? Or am I greater than 40, how old am I, 44? Greater than 44, in which case I'm old.
Though if you ask, the tree that you drew isn't quite right though, right?
Yeah, it is.
Because if you go down the false branch, it means you are less than 20.
No, I could be greater than 30.
Oh, good one.
Yes, I'm very clever. Or at least I accidentally got it right. One of the two is the same thing. Okay, so there you go.